Hello Izmir 2021, this is Moji Heydari from the Audio Information Retrieval Lab at the University of Rochester, New York. In this video, I will give you a brief review of a recent BeatNet project. BeatNet is an online joint music beat, downbeat and meter tracking system, leveraging CRNN and a two-stage cascade of Monte Carlo particle filtering. So let's take a look at our main contribution quickly. To our best knowledge, BeatNet is the first causal joint beat, downbeat and meter tracking system. It also delivers the state-of-the-art online beat tracking performance. The proposed information gate makes the inference process much faster than the baseline sampling rate models. The utilized cascaded state space is much smaller than the baseline efficient model, and also the system doesn't need to be primed with the time signature to perform downbeat tracking, and is instead able to estimate the meter and adjust the predictions over time. So here is a BeatNet pipeline. The system input is a raw audio waveform. The pre-processing step takes the information to the frequency domain frames with 20 millisecond time granularity before feeding them into the neural network block. The neural network comprises causal, convolutional, and recurrent layers to ideally model the dependencies across both frequency and time domain. The neural network delivers three outputs for each time frame: beat activation, downbeat activation, and non-beat activation. Next, the beat and downbeat activations are fed into the inference module. The inference module includes the proposed information gate and a cascade of two-stage particle filtering, one for beat tracking and the other for downbeat and meter tracking. So let's take a look at the input. The inference input is beat and downbeat activation. The beat tracking module is expected to infer the correct beat positions, and the downbeat tracking block detects the downbeats out of the inferred beats. The information gate first filters the meaningful data versus the noise by thresholding the activations, and then disables the expensive particle filtering resampling for the frames below the threshold, so that in the following example, the resampling is only accomplished for the orange area. It leads to times faster inference process. For the beat tracking, the Krebs state space model is utilized. It comprises two axes, one denoting the frame phase within the beat interval and the other representing the tempo. However, we didn't follow their fashion for downbeat tracking and didn't concatenate several beat state spaces to form a bar state space. The reason is that such a model increases the number of states drastically, as demonstrated in the figure. Also, for each time signature, a different state space is required. We instead utilize few states each to represent a beat area within a bar. It eliminates the need for multiple beat concatenation. Moreover, it lets us extend it to represent several bar lengths and provide dynamic meter tracking. Hence, the downbeat state space comprises two axes, the meter and the beat phase within the bar. The inference model is the same as our previous don't look back model. The particles are distributed randomly and by the time and within a recursive process converge to the correct location in the state space. The evaluation table includes the F-measure performance of the proposed model against several other online models. Note that for the supervised models, only the results of unseen datasets in the training stages are reported. As demonstrated, the BeatNet beat tracking outperforms all models. Also, it accomplishes the online downbeat tracking jointly. Moreover, it is around 4 times faster than the DLB model, which is another sampling-based model we proposed earlier. In addition, the offline comparison is accomplished to compare the neural network structure of the BeatNet versus a baseline non-causal joint neural network structure by using the same offline inference model. Now let's see how the system works for the background music.